My friends, so today we will cook perhaps the most classic Italian dish. Have a look.
Spaghetti al pomodoro San Marzano.
You got it right, it's spaghetti al pomodoro, but it's not any tomato, it's San Marzano. Come closer and I will show you what we need for this. You see, it's not too many ingredients. It's actually, I have more fingers than the number of ingredients we will need for our sofrito. Sofrito is what you start almost any Italian dish. You fry onion, garlic, a very little bit of carrot and a very little bit of celery. In our best friend, the olive oil, we got here our extra virgin home pressed olive oil from the season. And after a few minutes, you will add tomato, but not any tomato. You will add San Marzano. Means that this comes from this particular region, San Marzano. So we will cook this for at least 1 hour. That is really important on low flame. We will add also a little bit, actually not a little bit, but we will add basil, some leaves, and let this cook on low flame for 1 hour. And then we are ready to cook the pasta spaghetti. We will cook them 1 to 2 minutes before al dente, and the final minute we will cook them together with the pan where we will prepare this. And we will of course also add a little bit of salt. And the first step is we will cut these ingredients, but in the interest of time I will use the magic move. The ingredients have been cut, so this is all you need for 3 portions, really important. And all this will melt away in the slow cooking process. I also want to highlight, this is about 1/3 of the onion that you have seen. What I also want to say is, the quality of the result will very much depend on the quality of the ingredients, in particular these 3 ingredients. If you have quality tomato, quality olive oil, and quality spaghetti, you can't do much wrong. And if you watch this video recipe till the end, there are a few techniques that you will learn during this recipe that will also help. So next step, we will bring this olive oil on heat, medium flame. So that will be enough, this amount. And soon we will add these ingredients. So we are now ready to add the carrot, the celery, the garlic, and the onion. We will wait about 5 to 10 minutes until it has fried a little bit, and then we will add the San Marzano tomatoes. They have really a characteristic taste because they grow in this volcanic soil in Campania region. Oh, the smell is incredible. This is my preferred spot. So after about 5-6 minutes of frying, we are ready to add the San Marzano. Let's see. We will have to squeeze them a little bit like this. You can use this wooden spoon, and soon they will spread all the flavors. Now it's really important, don't overheat. Keep on low to medium flame when it starts, when it has actually started boiling. You can reduce, you can even reduce the flame and partially put a cover on top. Has been cooking for a few minutes. Now it's the time for basil, the first dose. And we also want a second dose of basil. It's really, really important. And actually also a booster. So it will really all melt away. Don't worry, it won't be as green as it is now at the end. And so let this cook on low flame for 1 hour. By the way, I also want to add a little bit of salt. There we go, and another little bit. Ah, my friends, so after about 1 hour of cooking, I think I will have to do a quality check. So now, let's start boiling the water. We cook the spaghetti, and in the final minute we cook the spaghetti in the sauce, and then we're ready.
Okay, so spaghetti have almost cooked al dente. I will now save a little bit of pasta water that we may mix later into the sauce. And the next step is we will put the spaghetti into the sauce and cook them for the final minute. mixing the spaghetti. So one more minute, they will cook until they are really al dente. This way, the spaghetti can soak all the nice sauce into the pasta. That you need to catch. Spaghetti al pomodoro San Marzano. My friends, thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Down there in the description, you will find those few ingredients that I used. And yeah, if you have any questions, feel free to use the comments function also down there. And buon appetito. Yeah, let's see.